Oh, he's gonna redirect it. I want a bar.
Right, hold on. Okay. Two couches. I'm Eric.
Two couches.
Okay. You're me.
Okay.
You're me looking at Eric. Okay? And then this is Eric. Like, he's sleeping, he has a sheet, and then he's like this. Okay, first he's like this.
Yeah.
He's sleeping. Then this guy, like, I look at him, I'm like, okay, he's done, right? And all of a sudden, like, his hand is here. Like, there, right? I'm like, what the fuck? His legs open up, and then he's like this, right? So I'm like, what the fuck is this guy doing? Right? So then, like...
I'm looking at Marvel now, right?
Yeah.
Like, two matches pass by. Now he's two-handing it now. Like, and I'm like, it's here. Like this. And he's grunting his teeth, like that. Mad hard, like... Emotion.
Like emotion.
I'm like, yo, look at this guy. Yo, what is he doing? Like, he's like, and yo, a week later, he said one of his teeth came out or something like that. It just,
what?
Yeah, from grinding his teeth. I was like, damn, yo. He's like,
wow.
Like,
wow.
And I'm like, damn.
He was all into that shit.
I don't know what he was thinking about, yo. He does not believe me, yo. I was like, man. You had to be there to see that, though.
Dude, that's fucking hilarious. Only New York, man.
Do you have a better true Marvel story?
I think we used up all the good ones, man. Like, I don't know. That horror story is pretty good.
That's not a Marvel story.
Yeah,
yeah, but it's a good story, though. I mean...
You can't beat that story?
Like, there's Jurgens, that's already been told. There's,
Roger.
There's the I need a dick. That's already been told.
I need a dick. Dick.
There's the all the spooning that goes on in New York. That's already been told.
What
an asshole. I don't know, man.
I've got good stories, but they're not really the Marvel.
So, well, are they in like the Capcom gaming scene?
Just shit that's happened to me.
I mean, like,
I almost got kicked out of college. That was fun.
What happened?
Well, that's a long story, but it's a good story.
You got time, man.
Wanna hear it?
You got nothing but time.
All right. Sorry.
No worries. It'll go back.
Directly onto your bare toes.
You have to walk around for this one.
Yeah.
Well, basically in college, my room was the party room, because me and my roommate both got scholarships to college. So our room was like at the corner of the dorm, so we had our own bathroom, like a huge closet. It was like the best room in the whole fucking dorm. So we had parties every day. And, well, one party, this girl had come, and she already had a boyfriend, yada, yada, yada. I messed around with her, whatever. A week after that, we had another party, and she came again. So we're having a party, and we had so much liquor. It was, like, ridiculous. We must have had a whole fridge full of beers, which must have been, like, 3 or 4 30 packs. We had handles of anything you could think of, tequila, vodka. I mean, it was ridiculous, and everyone in the dorm was there. So... some idiot gets the idea that they want to smoke, too. Now, it's one thing to have that much alcohol, but then mixing...
You have herb, yeah.
You know, it's really pushing it. So someone goes, gets herb, they're smoking in our bathroom. I'm like, oh, this is kind of getting out of hand. But as long as we keep it under control, we should be straight. So, party goes on longer. Two girls get really drunk. One of them was the girl that was actually I was messing around with. She passes out on my bed. Another girl who actually was a friend of ours passes out in her bathroom. Like, neither of them can move. They're so fucked up. So we're all there, and it's maybe about 1:30 in the morning. Party's just about to end. All of a sudden, bang, bang, bang. What the fuck is that? And we look around. The fire alarm went off.
Wow.
Now, do you know what happens when the fire alarm goes off at college?
No.
Basically, it's total lockdown. Everyone must leave the dorm regardless of what time it is. You lock your doors, and what happens is the RA goes to every door and unlocks it to make sure no one was asleep so he can get them out in the event of a fire. So I hear the alarm go off. I go, oh, shit. And I get up, and I'm like, we have to get everyone out. And I turn around to look for my roommates. Everyone ran out the fucking room except for me. Now I got two passed out girls in my room. I'm like, motherfucker. I can't carry two girls at once. It's impossible. So I said, all right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run downstairs real quick, see if it's a real fire. It's a real fire. I'll tell them there's girls up there, and we'll all run up and save them. But I can't carry two at once. I'll, you know, kill myself or whatever.
Yeah.
So I run all the way downstairs. It's not a real fire. Someone had pulled an alarm, some bullshit. We don't know what's going on with that. Later on, I actually find out what really happened. The girl who I was messing with had a crazy boyfriend. He came looking for me. with a fucking, like, Bowie knife. And he was so drunk when he showed up, he didn't know what dorm I was in. He didn't know what room I was in, but he knew what dorm I was in. So he just started going crazy, like, with the Bowie knife, and someone called the police, and he cut some fucking water pipe with the Bowie knife.
What?
And somehow, it was so crazy fucking story that he set off the fire alarm, basically, trying to get me out of the building. So anyway, so we go outside, and I'm like, all right, I'm safe, you know, there's no real fire, we're gonna be good. Next thing I know, I see the girl who I was messing with walking down the stairs, totally pissed drunk with a firefighter. I'm like, oh, shit. So she walks up to the corner, and the way it was is like, imagine this is the corner of the stairwell right here.
Yeah.
She walks up, and she walks down the stairs, she gets to the last stair, she goes, I'm okay, and the firefighter's right here, and she goes, bleh, all over his crotch, so he's fucking covered in fucking vomit. He's like, oh, you bitch. He's like, nice. So pissed. So they fucking cart her back to her apartment. Of course they caught me out. So they drag me and my roommate back up to our room. And they go, well, we got bad news for you. Like, what's that? Like, not only did we find alcohol, but we found a bowl sitting on your sink. So now we have legal right to search your entire premises for drugs. So they start tearing apart our apartment. Now keep in mind, at this point, it's like almost 3, 4 in the morning. We were there from 3 or 4 in the morning till 7 in the morning while they ripped our fucking apartment apart. Imagine going through your house and just ripping your drawers out, throwing your clothes on the fucking floor. And as they're doing this, they're piling it in a pile in the center of our room just to say, fuck you, look at what we can do. Tore our bed apart and everything. So the funniest part of the story is that there was drugs in the room. A big bag of fucking, like a chunk of weed was all that was left because I guess they had smoked it all. And it was actually sitting on the counter of my friend's computer that said, like, it was right here.
Yeah.
And the stupid fucking dude, the firefighter, he goes, what was it? It was actually campus security.
Yeah.
He goes, oh, we gotta look for drugs, and I hear that these kids, they hide it inside their computers these days.
What?
So we have to check inside the computer. I'm like, dude, this guy's a fucking idiot. So he goes, I swear to God, he goes like this, he grabs the side of the computer, he unscrews it, he takes the side off, and as he takes the side off, he knocks the weed off the desk onto the floor, and he stomps on it like that and tracks it into the rug. So they never found the drugs.
Oh, shit.
Me and my roommate and I were cracking up in front of the fucking guy. He's just such a fucking idiot. But basically, we almost got kicked out of school for that. We ended up having to do, like, 20, 30 hours of community service and paying a fine. Yeah. Like, if you ever catch you drinking on campus ever again, you'll be expelled permanently. And we'll make sure you never get into another college.
Shit.
So, needless to say, I moved off campus next semester. Yeah. I commuted for the rest of my college career.
What the movies? It was me. It was Jose and Jose's brother and his girlfriend and some other people. It was like a group of people. And we were waiting in line to get the tickets, right? And so Jose's brother gets up in line to get the ticket. And then the dude that was, you know, the cashier or whatever, he was like, well, you just cut in front of that dude. And like he wasn't even waiting for a ticket or anything.
No, I think what happened is we were seeing different movies or something. I know we were deciding what to see, but his brother knew what he wanted to see, so he goes first. He goes in line to get the ticket.
Well, anyways, like, the cashier accuses him of, like, jumping in front of somebody. And so he starts this big shit and calls the police over there or whatever. And so they take his brother over to the side and start, like, you know, talking to him and trying to take him into custody or whatever. And then fucking Jose goes in there and he's like, get your hands off my brother! And, like, fucking the cops are, like, trying to hold him down or something.
Well, mall security was there for the attendee wanted to fight Jose's brother. And they got into it. And, like, mall security comes, and then the real cops come, and, you know, the cops were being dicks or whatever, they just think that, like, he was starting shit, so they, like, physically, you know, like, you know, force him out of the way, his brother, like, for no reason. Jose, this is how Jose describes it, like, he said, like, he first said, he, like, this is a big guy, this cops, you know, like, right here, he gets, pushes the guy out of the way, and he puts his hands like this. And the thing is, the cop falls down. And so now the cop is pissed. And so the cop gets back up, grabs Jose.
Grabs him by the shirt.
Grabs him by the shirt. And Jose does some, like, Jose, fucking ninjutsu, like, shit. Comes out of the shirt.
So he's fucking shirtless.
Now he's shirtless in the mall. This is.
Okay. It's like in December. It was fucking the winter. And he fucking jets out the fucking doors. With no shirt. He's running through the mall.
No, before that, the other cop comes over. And tries to grab Jose too,
and he ends up slipping away, so they both fall down. And he's like, oh shit. And by this time, people are looking around and like...
like congregating and shit.
And so he takes off running through the parking lot.
And he fucking busts through the door, and other people on the side of the door, and it knocks this girl down. And this girl's boyfriend was like, what the fuck are you doing? So he starts chasing after Jose. And Jose's fucking running through the parking lot shirtless. And he hops into his car and drives to one of her friend's houses with no fucking shirt. He's like...
He said he ran around the parking lot for like 15 minutes trying to find his car.
And like we had to like talk to the cops because like they still had his brother and they weren't going to let him go until Jose came back. So we had to fucking, oh man. He had to like fucking negotiate with him and shit. Wow.
Did I say he ain't get trouble in that? Oh, he had to do like hours and hours.
Yeah, he
got banned from the mall.
He got banned from the mall for like a year.
It was
shit, at least my trouble was over pussy. You guys had a fucking movie ticket.
That shit was interesting.
Tickets, man. Stop. Isaac's a bitch. Here's my Isaac.
Bottom.
Alright. The Hills Have Eyes is about to come out like the next weekend. Like, this is the week before it came out. And we're all like, man, we gotta go see a movie. Like, when you see the preview on there and shit. And we look at Isaac, like, Isaac, we're gonna go see it next weekend, right? And he's sitting there like, man, I cannot go see that movie. I cannot at all. And I'm like, come on, man, it's not even gonna be that scary tonight. And he's like, man, I've been to the desert before.
That's a bad experience.
Been to the desert before. I can relate to what these people are going through, man. I can't put myself in a situation like that. Like, how am I gonna sleep at night? And I was sitting there like,
wow.
Pretty much the man that says he wants to see a video of a man
getting shot by a horse. Yeah, this man wants to see the video of a man getting killed by a horse that's fucking... I mean, the man's not gonna get killed, you know, he'll get kicked in the face by a horse.
He was
shit.
Like, did he die during it? Because that would be cool.
Yeah, he was like, if he died during this...
the best video ever.
If he died while best getting killed by the horse, would have been the best video ever, and I hope you saved it on your... But he won't see the Hills Have Eyes. He won't see that shit for nothing. Because it's been to the desert before. But
I
didn't
go. Nothing.
He didn't look good in himself.
I was like, what's up?
Dude, I want to see that shit, though. Because, you know,
where's Isaac at when we're telling his story? He needs to be out here and defend himself.
We can't defend that, man. Isaac, come here and defend that shit, man.
What is he doing? I think he's thinking crap.
He didn't get hurt.
Wait, it's about Chaz?
He followed Predator.
No. Okay, that movie, right?
What movie? What movie?
So hard, like, there was puddles everywhere, right?
What movie?
Alien vs. Predator, right? And I must add, that movie was just...
I heard it was stupid.
It could have been so good.
But it was funny. We were laughing at it. We were literally laughing at it. But this is what happened. It rained in the parking lot. So now, basically, I think we're late for the movie. So now, we're running. Now, but Chaz is running faster than all of us. Right?
He's eager to get
there. So I'm a little behind him, right? I'm running pretty fast, right? But I'm running a little bit behind him. And then Josh, like, I think he's not really running because he's not wearing sneakers. So now, what happens is, I'm slowing down because it's starting to get, like, more water on the ground, right? And now, what happens is Chaz, he doesn't slow down, right? And he sees a puddle on the ground and he jumps. Like freaking Olympic jump. He's like this, like literally, like like one of those. Like,
the one-footed leap, man.
Now, he didn't know when that puddle ended, and he was nowhere near the end.
Oh, shit.
Literally, that puddle was like 20 feet long.
Oh, my God.
I'm like,
man, thought he could make it.
Yo, I was like, I see him jumping. I'm like slowing down right there. I'm like this. I'm like, and he's in the air. I'm like, what is he doing, right? And so as he's jumping, I'm walking around the puddle. He's still in the air. I start going to the right. I'm walking around. He lands, and this is him. He's like this. And then he's like, and then he lands on his stomach, and like he slides 15 feet down.
It's like a slip and slide.
He slides 15 feet down there, like spinning around on the pavement. And then this dude, he was all the way at the end, and he's like, Chaz passes him, and he's like, safe.
Oh my God! Yo, man, that's perfect.
Oh man!
I was like, oh man, this guy's hardly right. So me and Josh, Josh, he walked up. He's like, yo, and we walked up. You all right? He's like, yeah, yeah. Then we started laughing. No, we didn't start laughing right away. He went to the bathroom. And he had to use one of the things that he... It's to dry his clothes.
Oh, man, he had to dry his clothes and that shit. He had to, like, improvise it. Yeah.
So we're in the movie theater. We're just laughing. And everybody's looking at us like, what the fuck are these guys laughing at?
And that's why Alien vs. Predator was funny. It was funny anyway, man.
It was
bad. Yeah, let's go get it on tape right now. Let's go get it blessed on tape.
Wait, let me see this shit. I don't believe
it's not big, but it's on the bed. It's on the second.
Like ketchup or some kind of condiment.
What? We believe that's blood.
Yeah, that's blood.
Like a Merlot, actually.
A Merlot, actually.
You got the bugs in the wall, too?
Show them the cockroach.
You got the
cockroach.
It's
from 1978 Merlot.
They're
fucking
pants in the back. Yeah,
and the room service
left. I saw exactly where it was.
Yo. I was about to take a shower and there was
squash cockroach brought to you by the Red Carpet Inn.
It was a roach, man. Is that even a cockroach? Have you ever seen a cockroach that can fly?
Like, I don't want to kill it or nothing like that. I'm like,
I seen it!
Oh, you got the cockroach to take.
Oh, man.
Hold on. Get this. I'm going to give him the chance to explain. To defend yourself, okay? We were saying why you didn't want to go see The Hills Have Eyes.
I'll just say that acid is a hell of a drug. And that's all I'll say.
By the way, it's cocaine.
Yeah, it's cocaine. Dude, I was in the desert and I was with friends and we were tripping on acid and it was just a bad day. We'll leave it like that. That's why, like, you know, I can
tell us the story.
No. I won't say the story, but that's why there is some fucked up shit that I can appreciate and then there's some fucked up shit that I can't appreciate. There's a limit on the level of fucked upness that I can handle, you know?
Fucked up.
Well, you know, seeing a guy, I mean, I think that's pretty fucking funny, like, seeing a guy die on tape if he's getting fucked by a horse, like, I think that's kind of funny.
Exactly.
Seriously?
Yeah, exactly. When I heard that, I was like, what?
He's like, I don't want to see
like, I was about to sleep, and I'm like, what?
Yeah, fully awake. He's like, what? I don't want to see him sleep after that. But if you could give me a tape of a guy getting fucked by a horse, and he dies while I'm sleeping, that's the best tape ever. I want to see this shit.
What
quote,
you said?
Unquote. Quote,
exactly. I was like,
Isaac Graham.
Said, I want to see his cock.
Isaac Graham from New York.
From New York.
Yeah, we need a soundbite of that.
Like, think about that.
Isaac Graham from New York said that.
They're going to have it.
Think about that going into a guy's ass. Like, that would, like, puncture his stomach. Like, I can only imagine how it punctured his colon. It's more scientific, you know? It's a scientific thing.
Nah, that horse was packing.
He was packing. That's what I heard.
All horses are packing. And then, like, when he came, like, did it explode, like, out of his ass? And then, like,
like a pressure valve.
Like, the horse pulled out, like, money shot on the guy's face? Like, what really happened?
Yo, was it a Mustang?
A Mustang. It was a black Mustang. The black horse.
Yo, the horse. The horse wasn't broken in and shit, you know?
Damn. Why?
I don't know.
Horse was
like, it's like pressure. It's like one of them fire hoses from the...
He's like...
Just full blast. Man.
It shoots like one of them fucking toy rockets that you like with the water pressure. You shoot something like that.
Man, I don't want to ever see that video. I'm sorry.
Yeah, man. Thank you for deleting it.
Dude, listen, just for science, it would be.
Oh like, yeah,
science for scientific purposes.
What science do you have that involves fucking horses?
What do you want?
Exactly. Like, would you like? That's one of those things. Like you have the chance, like
psychology.
Within a lifetime,
exactly.
To see something. Like I will never. Ever see a video like that ever again? And you screwed it up for me because you deleted it off your computer.
And you can't get it anywhere.
You can get that.
I don't even know. Like, what would you search for on Google? Like, guy getting fucked by a horse and having colon explode or something like that?
Hey, that's probably exactly what's gonna be in the website. .com.
You might get a man.
Just put .com. That's the name of the site.
I am pretty sure that someone's gonna leak that out.
Sure, but like,
no, it's public.
Yeah, he said it's already been leaked, but like,
how long can it be?
It's like the Paris Hilton video, just not enjoyable either.
Wow. Google. I don't want to see that thing.
Yeah, don't even search for that shit.
Wow. Wow. It's like seeing Lemon Party, like,
that, compliment. That, no, that was
worse than that. You said that he suffered for like, hours. I'm like, damn.
Yeah, that must have been some serious,
so
like,
what has to go through in your mind?
Exactly, like,
I'm suffering because I got pushed by a horse.
I was, in the video, did you see the guy's face?
I wasn't watching the video that closely.
Because what would his facial expression be like?
I think you saw his ass.
Oh my god.
Wow. Is he smiling? Is he,
is he enjoying it?
Can you tell that the ass end?
At the ass end.
That's,
it's a happiness to
wow.
Wow.
Yo, don't even just forget
on,
about it. Forget
I don't
about
want
it.
To see that.
Hey, no,
I'm just gonna find it.
That shit would be hilarious.
I know he's gonna find it, and
he's gonna bring him.
It was gonna he's gonna find that shit,
and
he's gonna put it as my screensaver. And that shit's gonna be locked as soon as that shit happens. He's gonna be locked, and I'm gonna see
me. That's more disturbing than hilarious. Like,
what's more disturbing?
Are you kidding me? She died. She did.
You're saying The Hills Have Eyes is more disturbing than seeing that video?
No, the only reason that it's more disturbing to me is because of my personal experience in the video.
Yo, what did you see? You saw people with,
what
like...
What happened?
Like,
did you run into the fucking people? I don't get it. I'm not even gonna... Did you find the Texas Chainsaw Massacre? Have you ever done acid before?
Huh?
Have you ever done acid before?
No, I haven't.
I won't even explain that.
So
I won't even explain it. Just,
so that movie's happened. Gonna make you have, like flashbacks and shit? Like, you...
Oh, something along those lines.
Wow.
That's a hell of a drug, man.
You must have been on the desert for like 8 hours.
He was like,
well, I mean, you've done acid, but so you know, like, trips, like, when you trip on acid, it's like 8 hours, and then you can't sleep the whole day next. So, like, you know, you trip, and then, like, you have flashbacks.
How did you get to the desert?
Why did you get to the desert,
man?
Someone was driving?
Yeah, I mean, like, we were driving, and then, you know, someone decided to do acid.
I don't want to
be here.
Like,
on the side of the road, and, like...
Yeah, that's
what
acid probably happens in the desert, man.
I don't want to
be here. It's a spontaneous acid trip.
Just because it's the desert.
I mean,
I'm from the Caribbean. I don't want to go next to the desert. Yeah.
Hell yeah, fuck that. Me too, man.
No green?
Yeah, it was hot.
Yeah, for real, no type of plants and shit. No palm trees?
Nothing,
sand.
Well, I
said you saw something.
The desert has
sand.
The fuck you,
like,
vultures, scorpions.
Yeah, man, they quicksand and shit, man. Fuck that.
I see the fucking
quicksand. I don't like quicksand. I'm scared of quicksand.
And nowhere on Discovery Channel does anybody get fucked by horses.
Nowhere. Discovery Channel puts that shit.
Oh, I trust the Discovery Channel.
It's like, for scientific purposes, according to Isaac Graham.
Scientific purposes, they don't say nothing about that. Anything about that.
I know. I've seen on Discovery Channel horses fucked by horses, so I wouldn't. Imagine a man fucked by a horse.
Yeah, that's bad enough. I couldn't stand watch through this shit.
Oh, it's just like, it's baffling.
Next on Animal Planet. Look what we found on the internet.
I prefer to be baffling.
No, what if they showed that on public TV? That would be fucking hilarious.
America's funniest.
Exactly.
Oh,
we got this
submit that shit.
We haven't checked it out yet. Let's see.
Oh.
So and Bob Saget, make a joke quick.
Bob Saget.
Came it up.
Oh, shit.
Bob Saget came up with that.
Wow.
Mm,
that
was
awesome.
Good.
Ooh.
All the stories.
Man wakes up. What happened? I'm trying to think. There's so many.
Is that
let me see what happened.
Can you beat the same
stories? No, there's some stories like there's one. There's this one time me and Patrick was playing. It was, I don't know, it was a good day. I mean, it was a normal day. We went out eating, having a good time. We got home, we played, right? We played a little Marvel, though.
What?
Five games in a game,
yeah.
Right? He's cursing me out for no reason.
I think it was
I beat him five straight, too. It's
video.
Not a problem. Man, chill, you know, it's cool.
But you don't eat
me, though. I'm like, you know, give him next game. He's thinking I'm talking shit.
You turned me on to that.
So he flips his stick. He flips his stick.
That's a big man to be
angry. He flips his stick. He punches one. He's like, why are you fucking talking shit? I'm like, I'm not talking. I didn't say you're being nasty. He walks outside. He's like, come outside right now. We fight.
Oh, shit.
He was serious, too. He's serious. He took off his shirt and everything.
We're just
Zach. Horrible.
Like, the ultimate
horrible. Why? Little me? You saw how pale he looks?
Come
on, I can beat him up. He has five brothers who are bigger.
What?
No, like, and he beat like a few of them. He beat like a couple of them up.
That reminds me of the first time.
Trust me, though. You know,
I just
seen
Patrick
fight.
and he fought D.
He hit me what?
And you ran away for 93 seconds of the match.
He wanted to beat him,
dude.
He wanted to really
beat me up. This guy from North Carolina wanted to fight me.
I've been in that situation.
Let's not get to that one. He knows that one too.
I'm not gonna say that one.
You wanna say it?
Did I tell you that one?
You did. I'm saying you wanna say it on camera.
No, I'm not gonna say
it. I wanna hear it. I never heard it.
You can speak for me. You can be my mouth.
I'm saying. My I'm not gonna say it because Arturo's my friend. I'm not gonna say it.
Do it.
Nah, I can't do it. Arturo's a cool guy. I can't.
All I know is one time in the last Mind Boggle tournament.
Yeah, that sounded like this one time from Big Kim.
No, that's what I mean, you know. All of New York stayed at Jose's house and people from Texas, whatever. And Jose's playing some guy in Guilty Gear and he's about to beat him. And the kid, you know, he resets the game. And Arturo comes up to him, he's like, "What the fuck did you do?" Dude, like, because, you know, it's like, this is his house. How are you disrespecting him like that? And like him and, you know, all of New York, they take him up to a room, shut the door. And all you hear is like, and he's screaming and fire. And then they're in there for like an hour and 45 minutes. And no one knows what happens.
Did you ever come to a Mind Boggle tournament? That was that one that Mike, the fucking one Mike hopped on the train.
Oh, that?
Yeah, that was the tournament.
I was supposed to go to that, but I didn't go.
Good shit.
I wasn't going to stand on the train, but I was to play more.
Well, you know when the Mike Infinite, like, you know,
He was sitting in the fucking chair.
So back in the day when, like, Street Fighter 2, the original Street Fighter 2 game,
yeah,
it was cheap to throw someone.
Yeah.
Like, if you do someone, like, no, let me get a throwback. You know, let me get a throwback. I'm like, now people like me, like, think it's a joke, but, you know, they were serious. So back in the day at my local arcade in Bridgeport, now I live in Bridgeport, Connecticut, which is actually the ghetto of Connecticut. And a lot of people are like, oh, Connecticut is rich. No, there's ghettos in Connecticut. That's not what I used to know. So there's this white dude, and he's playing, like, the original Street Fighter 2 against this, like, big Puerto Rican dude, like a gang of Puerto Rican dudes with him. So, alright, playing games, whatever. So he throws him, yo, let me get the throwback. He's like, no, I'm just going to keep playing. He's playing. Throws him again, yo, let me get the throwback. Cheesy motherfuckers. No, so he starts talking shit to this, like, gang of Puerto Rican dudes. Like, this guy's the dumbest person I've ever met. So, basically, after paying for like 2 hours, they're just like so heated.
Really?
And the kid, like, is like totally oblivious to what's going on, and the kid, guy goes up to him and goes, alright, just to let you know, we're going to go to something to eat, but we're going to be waiting outside for you. So we'll see you in about 15 minutes.
I'm going to have to get second again, you know?
So they walk outside, and one of them actually sits in the car waiting for this kid to come out of the arcade. So the kid is shitting his pants. So he goes into the bathroom, right? Where he's like, damn, he's like throwing up, or he's fucking pissing or shitting his pants because he's so scared.
I mean, overall,
15 minutes
overall,
past. I mean, a half hour past. The kid never comes out of the bathroom. Other people have to use the bathroom. Yeah. The door's not open. Like, dude, the kid is fucking hard. Now it's been like an hour and a half. The kid's not out. Like, something's wrong. So the owner gets the key, opens up the bathroom. It's empty. I was like, where the fuck did the kid go? So, alright, we don't know what happened. Maybe he fucking didn't go in the bathroom. Maybe someone was a mistake. So we're all playing games there, and all of a sudden, maybe like, you know, 2 hours after he went into the bathroom, we start hearing this noise. What is that noise we hear? Help! Where the fuck is that coming from? It's coming from the ceiling. They get a ladder, and they go up, and they pop out one of the squares.
Yeah.
The kid fucking climbed into the ceiling of the bathroom, into the ceiling tiles to try to get out of the arcade so that the kids would not beat his ass. Where the fuck did he think he was going in the ceiling?
Wow, man. You just get smarter by the second.
Dumbest person ever. It's like, ask if there's a back door. Don't try to climb the fucking ceiling tiles to get out. Holy shit.
Damn.
That was fun. The fire department came.
I have the fire department.
Yeah, he couldn't. They had to cut it out. They had to cut the fucking ceiling out because he was jammed in the ceiling.
Holy shit.
The fireman should have beat his ass.
He just gave him a booger right there.
Piece of shit.
Well, it's not crazy.
It's one hell of a way to avoid an ass whooping.
I was
going. Ooh, what the fuck is wrong with that?
Fit is like probably just mad old. And everything. Like, I think all the circuit breakers and shit like that are connected together. Some shit like that. I mean, I'm not an electrician, but I would assume that's how it worked. So it's just like one day, it's mad crowd in Chinatown. It's mad cold. It's all marble and shit. So I'm playing like, I think I'm playing somebody real, I'm playing Sanford, and I really don't want to get off, you know what I mean? So we're having like a really close game. So all of a sudden, like the lights, all the lights in CF start flashing. And I'm not really paying attention because I'm so into the match. And it's like one of these, like right behind Marvel. So then fucking, like, mad sparks just start shooting out of here. And like all the other cabinets just shut off. And like everybody's getting all scared and like moving away from the machine. But I'm so into the game, like I just keep playing while all this shit is going on around me. Sanford just gets off the game because he's scared. And I'm just still playing. I don't even notice. And then like, everybody just like pulls me off the machine. And that was it.
Oh my god.
Nice.
The Marvel machine didn't even go off?
No, it did after a while.
Shit.
Crazy. That was crazy. Damn.
Arcade burns out. Just
Arcade was done. Arcade was done for a while.
LemonFry.org. What are some other good ones?
I can't remember the address.
Tubboy.
I've never seen Tubboy.
It's either .net or .com.
I've seen Tubgirl, and I can only imagine what.
Wait,
Tubboy.
I might have the new Combo Master on my laptop.
They have a new they have a new Combo Master.
They redid it. Just it's the same thing, but they put it on a new website because the other one got shut down.
We're about to find out about the new Combo Master.
That's a funny fucking thing, dude. The smile on that guy's
face. Do you remember Combo Master?
Weird.
He's going like this.
His smile, dude. A big fucking white
you
smile.
You sent me some sick shit, some sick links, so I know that like.
You automatically assume.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I automatically
assume. That was such a long time ago. That was like 2 years ago, though.
So Combo Master was really
original. Like, I didn't
like,
forget it.
That's right, I showed you Tub Girl. Crazy. I showed you Tub Girl, and I showed you. I think I showed you Combo Master.
So exciting, Craig. Some shit going on some girl's ass.
Yeah, Tub Girl.
Nasty, dude.
Everyone knows about Tub Girl, but Tub Girl got shut down.
Yeah.
Now they have Tub Boy, though. Okay. Tub Boy, it's not the same. It doesn't have the same impact.
You sounded mad, disappointed.
It's just not the same. Things
like
changing,
like the story doesn't have the arc that Tub Girl had. Like
doesn't
an arc
the...
of like that. It's just kind of like a limp arc. Like
the quality is just not there.
And like the shit in the bathtub is like maybe this big.
You get a Eve for effort.
It is terrible. They did a really bad job.
Yeah,
they did a really
bad.
They did a really
bad. Man,
I would
hate
I don't know
that.
If I have
holy
it.
Shit.
The I have one anyway. Icon on my desktop.
Yeah, right.
Lemon Party.
Yeah, my computer.
LemonParty.org.
Look at it. Look.
Their
website. See the screen.
Do you have the new Combo Master?
I'm. I don't know. I know I have.
Come on, man. Wait.
I do it, but I fucked them so hard when it came.
Oh, that's even more reason to do it.
Exactly.
Oh,
listen, alright, if you fuck with them this time,
not only would I give away the hardest bracket possible, like, I just fucking, like,
listen, this time, I'll let him kill himself, okay?
Do it.
Boom.
Cable guy.
That means you gotta fuck with
him. Cable guy.
So you wanna do it?
I haven't
spoken to
him since. I don't know
what you're
screaming
and shit. I don't know. You talk to fucking Chunk, you're
fine,
know it. They're best friends and shit.
Chunk, you're best friends?
No, but I mean they're friends.
Cable guy.
That's fucking annoying too.
He's cool.
No, he's cool in an annoying way. He's just like, Jazz, what's good? Every time I come back to the computer, wait, what's up?
Sounds like Eddie.
Eddie is Isaac's best friend, by the way.
No.
His favorite E friend.
You was any red shit
over this? Yeah, I
love
the second
one.
Yeah,
this
is a bag.
Again.
It's probably
yeah.
My bag.
Yeah, I think
I
saw
it.
Nice. I've given
him a cold
before.
So it's Frody.
Old shit that I don't want anymore.
Man, that's just serious, man.
Tough.
You have to find him a hold.
Get an identity.
It's been tried.
Get him an alternate identity.
So he can travel.
What are you gonna do when you don't have an identity anymore?
Seriously, so that's one of the funniest
things. How do you survive?
How do you fix that?
For $20.
I don't know what to do. Like, I sold my social security card to someone for $20.
How do you go
my
to
my fucking
DMV?
Social security card, my birth certificate. Did he have a license?
No.
I don't even know about the answers yet.
He had an ID.
He had what?
I think he had an ID.
Oh, he had an ID?
You need ID.
He didn't have a government ID.
He
doesn't have a government ID because he doesn't have enough points of information to get it.
Man.
So he really doesn't exist.
What's your home address, sir?
He really doesn't exist.
He has no legal residence.
And yeah. For 10
wait, I thought he was going back to school.
How? Sure. Sure. Sure, Sam.
Sammy can barely read. Does everything on spell check before he types his post?
On his MySpace.
Yeah, I don't know how he has a MySpace, but he doesn't own anything.
Oh my god, he has a MySpace?
Dude, go to Pete Zanga. I'm gonna give you the link. Go to, like, it's like MySpace, yeah. Yeah. Some guy, yeah, but.
No, I'm saying he's a yacht.
Oh, he's a yacht. He's past the yacht.
But because he plays rope.
No, just the way, it's not the way. It's the way he plays. It's not like what he's. I don't know. It's not who we play.
Like, it's, you know how, like the Marvel players, like, they have certain ads and shit?
Yeah.
Like, and then those people who are from like, yeah, they just have weird, like, extravagant patterns, like, I've never seen before.
Yeah, these beds are, like, wow. That looks
like something
like this bed.
What?
Like, fucking 2x4 holding the
door. I can see it right there. Dude, when we went to, that's a good story. When we went to fucking, what was it, Evolution 2003, I think, like, you remember the hotels back in Pomona, right? And you know how
they're
in Pomona.
Pomona,
whatever.
In Cal Poly?
Yeah.
I never went to those. I only went to 2002 and 2005.
Well, you remember that, right? You remember how the beds were on fucking, like, metal frames?
I don't
know. Well, picture James Page, like, jumping 12 feet in the air and landing on one of the beds, dude. The fucking metal bar snapped in half instantly. Hilarious, dude. Fucking hilarious.
Yeah, I haven't seen James in a while.
He's what? He's like
he a cop now?
Yeah, he's like a sheriff or something.
What?
I don't know if that's true though.
James is a sheriff.
Exactly, James.
How'd it happen?
He was looking for the job where he has to do the least amount of work to be good for it.
Wow.
I can see him. He's like, you guys, is that weed you guys got? I would confiscate that.
Dude, James is huge. He almost like broke my neck once. He doesn't even know his own strength.
Yeah, exactly.
Like he was choking me out, and like I heard something snap, and I thought it was my neck, and I'm like, oh my god. I'm die. James,
push it to the limit.
Safety is not guaranteed.
That's right. Don't fuck with James Page. Safety is not guaranteed.